So student, today we will look into the chapter waves. This is chapter 15 from NCERT, volume 2. Now, today I'm going to give you a brief introduction on the general equation of wave. So many students, they find this equation of the wave a bit confusing. So this class will be beneficial for them. Now, basically, when we say wave, now in class 11, we are talking about mechanical waves. In class 12, we have electromagnetic waves, light wave. So class 11, basically we'll be dealing about mechanical waves. Now mechanical waves, so we will be dealing on mechanical waves. That is waves which requires a material medium for their propagation. Now mechanical waves, they are of two types: transverse waves and longitudinal wave. So in transverse wave, the particles of the medium, they vibrate perpendicular to direction of propagation. So if this is the direction of propagation, the particles will vibrate like this. This is transverse wave. So you can see this wave in vibration in strings. Now longitudinal waves, the particles of the medium, if this is the direction of propagation, particles of the medium, they will vibrate parallel to the direction of wave propagation. So particles, they will vibrate like this. In this case, the particles, they will vibrate like this. So this is transverse wave and this is longitudinal wave. Now as you can see, in both the cases the particles, they are undergoing oscillations. So in this case the particles, they are undergoing oscillations in the vertical direction. In this case the particles, they are undergoing oscillations in the horizontal direction. So that means in the previous chapter we have seen that all the oscillations, all kind of oscillations are periodic. So that means if the oscillation, whether the oscillations are perpendicular to direction of propagation or oscillations are parallel to direction of propagation, all these oscillations are periodic. So periodic, we have periodic oscillations. Periodic oscillations. Acha, so now next we will try to frame an equation for the displacement of the particles undergoing these oscillations. So that will represent the general equation of the wave. So now let us represent a transverse wave again. So this is a transverse wave. Now suppose this is your x-axis and this is your y-axis. Now this is one wave. So from this point to this point, the total distance in terms of wavelength is lambda. If we represent the wavelength as lambda, in terms of time, if this is t equal to 0, this is t equal to 0, this will be t equal to t. So that means this total time is t. That is one oscillation. This is one oscillation. So this is the total time t. This is the total distance lambda. Now this is the displacement of particle. Particle is undergoing displacement in the upward direction, then again in the downward direction. So at this particular position, this is the origin. So origin, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So at this particular, and particles are undergoing displacement along y-axis. Particles, remember, the particles are vibrating along y-axis and wave is propagating along x-axis. This is a transverse wave. So if the particles are vibrating along y-axis, so at this particular position you have x is equal to 0, t is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. That means displacement of the particle is 0 when time t is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. This is the displacement of the wave. Now if you see this, suppose this is the amplitude. So this is a and this is minus a. So this is amplitude. That is the maximum displacement of the particle from the mean position. Okay, now if you see this particular time, see from this point to this point, the total distance is lambda. From this point, the total distance is lambda. So from this point, the distance will be lambda by 2. That means from this point, the distance will be lambda by 4. So for this particular point, x is equal to lambda by 4. Okay, now from this point to this point, if the total time is t, by the same logic, I can say that this time is t is equal to t by 4. Achha. Now what is the value of y? Y is equal to a. Y is equal to a at this particular point. Similarly, if you see this particular point, displacement of the particle. See, so this is the displacement of the particle. Y is equal to a when? When time t is equal to t by 4 and displacement of the wave is x equal to lambda by 4. Similarly, for this particular point, displacement of the particle is 0. Now, displacement of the particle is again 0. At this particular position also, displacement is 0. So, again, the displacement of the particle at this particular location is 0. When x is equal to how much? This total distance is lambda. So, this much distance will be lambda by 2. Lambda by 2. And what is the time? This total time is t. So, how much will be this time? This will be t by 2. So, as you can see, the displacement of the particle depends on the value of x, that is the displacement of the wave, and the time t. So from this observation, can we conclude that displacement of the particle, it is a function of x comma t. X is the displacement of the wave, t is the time. This is the value of y, that is the displacement particle, depends on time and x. Again, here we can see y is equal to a when t is equal to t by 4, x is equal to lambda by 4. For this case, y is again 0 when x is equal to lambda by 2, t is equal to t by 2. So that means displacement of the particle is a function of x and t. Achha. Now, what can be the form of this function? What can be the form of this function? See, as we can see, this particle is undergoing oscillation, and in the previous chapter we have already seen that oscillations are always periodic. So all oscillations are periodic, but all periodic motions may not be symbol harmonic oscillations. Okay, so oscillations, essential condition for oscillation, one essential condition for oscillation is they are periodic. So this is a periodic motion. Displacement of the particle is a periodic motion. So that means this function, it has to be a periodic function. It has to be a periodic function. Okay. So periodic function we can have, that means we can have a sine function or a cosine function. Okay, you can have a sine function or a cosine function. So let us write, remember the displacement max, what is the maximum displacement in upward direction? This is plus a. Maximum displacement of the particle in the upward direction is plus a. Maximum displacement of the particle in downward direction will be minus a. This distance will be minus a, and this distance will be plus a. Okay, so let us write the equation of the wave as y is equal to a times sine of ax plus minus bt. Now this function of y is a function of periodic function, means I can write sine or cosine of x and t. A and b are some constants. Okay, a and b are some constants. Now see, this is a trigonometric function sine of ax plus minus bt. So this is a trigonometric function. That means this quantity must be a dimensionless quantity. Dimensionless quantity. Now, if this has to be a dimensionless quantity, that means this is displacement. That means this term A must have a dimension of L power minus 1. Correct? And this term B, this A and B are constants. In this equation, A and B are constants. So this term B, it must have, this is T, so this must be T inverse 1. T inverse 1. Okay. Now, if you can see dimensionally, if I write coefficient of T divided by coefficient of T divided by coefficient of X. Now, what is the coefficient of T? B. What is the coefficient of X? A. What is the dimension of B? It is T inverse 1. What is the dimension of A? It is L inverse 1. So that means this is L by T. L inverse 1, it will go up. T inverse 1, it will go down. So we have L by T. What is this? This is velocity or speed. Okay, so this is, I can say that this is the velocity of the wave or speed of the wave. Okay, so this term, this ratio must represent the speed of the wave. And it is going to represent, we will see it. Now, next thing is, let us write the general solution. Now, let us assume that this equation, see, this is the equation of the wave, means this is the most general form. This is the most general form of the equation. And I have assumed that the solution of the wave equation is of this form, y is equal to a sine ax plus minus bt. Okay. Now, let us see what is the implication of having a positive sign and what is the implication of having a negative sign in this equation. Now, see, this structure, it is going to represent a particular wave. Okay. Now, for a particular wave, the structure must remain constant. So, that means this form must remain constant for a particular wave. So, that means we can have ax plus bt. This is ax plus minus bt. This is a general solution. So suppose what happens when, if I write ax plus bt, and what happens when I write ax minus bt in this place? Okay. Now, as you can see, time is always positive. Okay, time is always positive. So as the wave progresses, this quantity is going to increase. This quantity is going to increase. Now, if this quantity is going to increase and this entire term should remain constant, that means x is negative. That means x is negative. X is going in the negative direction. Such that when this time is increasing, the bt is increasing. If x is going in the negative direction, so this form will remain constant. So that means, if we have ax plus bt, so this represents a wave propagating in which direction? In negative x direction. Okay, see, if this quantity, time is always positive, so as time progresses, this quantity is going to increase. So that means this quantity must decrease. Then only this entire structure ax plus bt will remain constant. So x must be negative, and it should increase in negative direction. So this wave is propagating along negative x direction. Similarly, if we have ax minus bt, so again, now this time can never be negative, so time is positive. So that means this quantity, as time is increasing, this quantity is decreasing. It is increasing in the negative direction. So that means x must, if this this form ax minus bt, this term must remain constant. So that is possible only when x is increasing along positive x direction. So that means this wave is propagating along positive x axis. Okay, so now we have understood in this equation, what is the implication of having AX plus BT? What is the implication of having AX minus BT? Okay. Now, in the next case, let us assume this the value of A and B. Okay. Now, let us take those values as, now again, I am taking another general equation. General equation as y is equal to a. Now I'm going to substitute the value. So just now we have seen that this coefficient of t must have dimension of t inverse 1, coefficient of x must have dimension of l inverse 1, because this entire quantity has to be a dimensionless quantity. So I'm writing y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t plus phi. Okay, so this term, this is the phase. This is the phase of the wave. Phi is the initial phase. This is the this thing kx minus omega t plus phi is the phase. Phi is the initial phase. Initial phase. Now what do you mean by initial phase? That is the phase at x is equal to 0, t is equal to 0. So this is the phi is the initial phase. Okay. So now let us obtain the differential equation of the wave from this equation. Okay. Now let us take this initial phase to be 0. Assume that phi is equal to 0. So I have y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. So kx minus omega t, ax minus omega bt, ax minus bt. So instead of a I have written k, instead of b I have written omega. Okay, now we will see later what are the form, means what form this k and omega takes. Okay, now since we have kx minus omega t, that means this is a wave which is propagating along positive x-axis. Now this is the displacement, this y is the displacement of the particle. Okay, y is the displacement of the particle, a is the amplitude, that is the maximum displacement of the wave of the particle from the mean position. Now if y is the displacement of the particle, if I write dy by dt, okay, now dy by dt will be how much? Dy by dt will be is equal to a cos kx minus omega t into minus omega. This is dy by dt. So that is equal to, that means dy by dt is equal to minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. Okay, this is dy by dt. Now let us find, so this is dy by dt. Okay, now let us find dy by dx. Okay, now dy by dt will represent the velocity of the particle. Achha. Now remember this equation sine kx minus omega t, this is the equation for this wave. This is y-axis and this is x-axis. So that means if I am finding dy by dx, for this graph you have written that equation. Okay, so dy by dx for this graph should give the slope of this graph. That means dy by dx should give the slope of this wave. This is a wave equation. This is a wave equation. Okay, so that means dy by dx will give the slope of the wave. So if this is y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. Okay, so what will be the value of dy by dx? Dy by dx will be how much? A cos kx minus omega t into, so differentiation of sine is cos, then in this kx minus omega t we have k, so this is into k. So dy by dx is equal to a k cos kx minus omega t. Okay, so this is the slope of the wave. This is slope of the wave. And this is earlier obtained equation dy by dt. It is the particle velocity. Okay. Now dy by dx represents the slope of the wave. If I differentiate this equation once again, so in mathematics you might have learned dy by dx represents the slope. Now if I differentiate this once again, d square y by dx square, what it will represent? It will represent the bending of the wave. So next is d square y by dx square. So this will give information of bending of wave. So if the bending is in the downward direction, is negative. So d square y by dx square, this is negative. Now if the wave is pointing in the upward direction, bending is in the upward direction, is taken as positive. So d square y by dx square, it will be positive. Okay, so second derivative will give you the bending of wave, bending, that is this bending, whether the bending is pointing in the downward direction or bending is pointing in the upward direction. So this information is very critical. Okay, so this is when bending is downward direction, d square y by dx square is negative. When in the upward direction, is taken as positive direction, so d square y by dx square is positive. Okay, so let us find the value of d square y by dx square from this. D square y by dx square, again different, we have to differentiate this once again. So ak, if you differentiate cos, it is minus sine kx minus omega t, and then you will get 1 k extra. So you have d square y by dx square is equal to minus this minus a k square sine kx minus omega t. So this is the information on bending. Okay, so let me write this equation once again. What did we get? We got d square y by dx square is equal to minus a k square sine kx minus omega t. Now we already have dy by dt as minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. This is the particle velocity. Now let us differentiate this equation once again with respect to time. So we have d square y by dt square is equal to minus a omega cos is minus sine kx minus omega t, and then this minus omega t, we have minus omega. So this minus plus, so totally we have how much? Minus a omega times omega is omega square sine kx minus omega t. Okay, so this is d square y by dt square. Now d square y by dt square. Now here we have sine kx minus omega t. In this equation also we have sine kx minus, So from this equation I can write sine kx minus omega t as minus 1 by a k square d square y by dx square. Okay, now the sine from this equation, I can write sine kx minus omega t as minus 1 by a omega square d square y by dt square. Okay, so if I equate these two equations, this equation and this equation, if I equate these two equations, I have minus 1 by ak square d square y by dx square is equal to minus 1 by a omega square d square y by dt square. So we have d square y by dx square is equal to how much? K square by omega square d square y by dt square. So this is the second degree differential equation for second degree differential equation. For wave, okay. Now, next, let's see. Still we haven't written, means we haven't written what is the value of k and omega. Okay. Now let's see what is the value of this, what this k and omega represents. Now, let us write the general equation of the wave again, once again. So y, it is a function of x comma t, and it is represented as a sine kx minus omega t plus phi. This is a general equation. Now let's say in this equation, let's say t is equal to 0 and phi is equal to, phi is also 0, phi is the initial phase. So that this equation becomes, see, t is equal to 0, phi equal to 0. So this is y of x comma t is equal to a sine, this general form. So y is equal to how much? X comma t 0 is equal to a sine kx. Okay. Acha. Now, this is the wave. Okay. Now, for this particular position, y is equal to 0. For this particular position, y is again 0. This is x equal to 0. This is x equal to lambda. That means if I shift the value of x through lambda, the particle displacement will remain same. Okay, so that means if this is true, that means if x is equal to x1, then for x equal to x1, if particle displacement is some value of y, then again if I write x is equal to x1 plus lambda, y particle displacement will be same. Okay, so particle will have same displacement if this wave is displaced through a distance lambda. So lambda, what is this lambda? Lambda is the wavelength. Lambda is the wavelength. Okay, so in this equation, if I write a sine kx 1, x is equal to x1, so particle will have a particular displacement as per this equation. So particle will again have same displacement if I write y is equal to a sine k, x is increased by x1 is, see, in this case x is equal to x1, again x1 plus lambda, so it is increased by value lambda. So it should be how much? The particle will have same displacement for value x is equal to x1, and then x is equal to x1 plus lambda. X1 plus lambda. So particle will have same displacement. This is the equation for displacement of the particle. Okay. So a sine kx1 is equal to a sine kx1 plus lambda. So I can write this equation as a sine kx1 is equal to a sine kx1 plus k lambda. Okay. Acha. Now we know that the sine function will repeat itself provided the value of this k lambda. See, this is sine a sine kx1. This is a sine kx1 plus k lambda. That means this k lambda must be equal to twice pi n, integral multiple of twice pi. So that means k lambda is equal to twice pi n. Correct? So that where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay, now lambda is defined for minimum distance between two points which are in the same phase. Minimum distance between two points which are in the same phase. For minimum distance is for n equal to 1. For n equal to 1, what is the value of k? k is twice pi by lambda. So this k is called propagation constant. K is called propagation constant. Or you can call it as angular wave number. Angular wave number. So we have defined k as twice pi by lambda, and k is called, it is known by the name propagation constant or angular wave number. Okay, now next let us see the what forms other this omega takes. Okay, now again in the general equation for the wave, let us take now x is equal to 0 and phi is equal to 0. Okay, so in this general equation, in this general equation of the wave, now we take x is equal to 0 and phi is equal to 0. Now if we take x is equal to 0 and phi equal to 0, what do you get? We get y of 0 comma t is equal to a sine minus omega t. So that is equal to how much? Is equal to, in this equation, in this equation, if I take x is equal to 0 and phi is equal to 0, you get a sine minus omega t, correct? Small a. Acha. So this can be written as I wrote amplitude as capital A, correct? Amplitude as is capital A. So this is capital A. This is capital A. This is, all these are capital A. Amplitude capital A. Okay. So this is again capital A. So I have this capital A. Amplitude is represented as capital A. Achha. Now, so y equal to 0 comma t. So this is a sine minus omega t. So this can be written as minus a sine omega t. Okay. So see, if the wave is, if the particle is having same displacement. So one case here we have seen, that means the wave is undergoing a displacement lambda. In terms of time, if I say the time that is passed is capital T, one time period, that is after one time period, the particle will have same position, particle will have same displacement. In this equation, if I write minus a sine omega t1, if time increases, see in this case, if position increases by lambda, your particle is having the same displacement. Similarly, if time increases by capital T, the particle will have same displacement. This is t equal to 0, this is t equal to capital T. So 0 plus capital T, if in this position particle is having 0 displacement, in this position again the particle is having 0 displacement. So particle will have same displacement if the time progresses by an interval capital T. So minus a sine omega t1 is equal, so this is minus a sine, so particle will have displacement this, for this particular time it will again have same displacement if time is minus a sine omega, time is increased by, this is t1, so time is increased by one time period, so this is capital T. So this is minus a sine omega t1 plus omega t. Okay, so sine repeats itself again after interval twice pi. That means this omega t value, this omega t, see this is minus a sine omega t1. Okay, so minus a sine omega t1 is equal to minus a sine omega t1 plus omega t. So that means this term omega t, this must be equal to twice pi n, where n is equal to 1, 2, n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, so we have omega t is equal to twice pi n. So again, for minimum value of n, minimum value of n is n equal to 1. So for n equal to 1, we have omega is equal to, if for n equal to 1, omega will be how much? Omega will be twice pi by capital T. So now we have obtained the value of omega, we have obtained the value of k. This is angular frequency. Omega is angular frequency. So this is propagation constant or angular wave number. Omega is angular frequency. Now, interesting thing is, see, initially when I started, I told you the general form as y is equal to a sine ax plus bt or minus bt. Now, instead of a, in place of a, so now we have k, okay, and in place of b, we have omega. And I told you coefficient of t, ratio of coefficient of t to ratio of coefficient of x, this is b by a, the ratio was equal to how much? Velocity. Okay, now we have k is equal to twice pi by lambda and omega is equal to twice pi by t. Now let's see what is the value of omega by k. Now what is omega? Omega is twice pi by capital T. What is k? K is twice pi by lambda. So this twice pi cancels. So we have lambda by T. Wavelength by time period. What is this? The wave velocity. Wave velocity. So omega by k represents wave velocity. Omega by k represents wave velocity. Now if we go to the previous equation, the second degree differential equation for the wave, we have d square y by dx square is equal to k square by omega square d square y by dt square. Now just now we have seen that the ratio omega by k represents velocity of the wave. So that means I can write this equation as d square y by dx square is equal to v square d square y by dt square. Okay. So differential equation of wave d square y by dx square is equal to 1 by v square d square y by dt square. Okay, so this is one final result. Now one more result that we need to see is relation between particle velocity and wave velocity. So particle velocity, we had dy by dt is equal to minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. Okay, this is particle velocity. I hope you have written this equation. And dy by dx, that is the slope of the wave, we have dy by dx is equal to ak this. So let me write this equation for you again. Particle velocity dy by dt is equal to minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. And slope of wave dy by dx is equal to ak cos kx minus omega t. Now from these two equations, I can write dy by dt is equal to dy by dt is minus a omega. Now instead of cos kx, from this, see cos, what is the value of cos kx from this equation? Cos kx will be 1 by ak dy by dx. So this a cancels out. We have omega by k. And just now we have seen, what is the value of omega by k? Omega by k is wave velocity. Omega by k is wave velocity v. So this is omega, this is k. So dy by dt is equal to minus omega by k dy by dx. So that is dy by, this implies we have dy by dt is equal to minus v dy by dx. Remember, this is wave velocity. Omega by k is wave velocity. Dy by dt is particle velocity. This is particle velocity. This is wave velocity. This is slope of the wave. So, and we have a negative sign. So, from this, we conclude that particle velocity is equal to minus velocity of wave multiplied by slope of the wave. So particle velocity is equal to minus of velocity of wave multiplied by slope of the wave. So this is the relation connecting particle velocity and wave velocity. Okay, so this is another very important relation. Now, another observation we can make is, see, in the beginning, as I told you, that the form of the equation must remain constant. This form remains constant. Now we have obtained that A is equal to K and B is equal to omega. So A is equal to K and B is equal to omega. So now kx minus omega t, this must remain constant. Okay, kx minus omega t must remain constant. So let us differentiate this and let's see what happens. So d by dt of kx minus omega t. So if you differentiate a constant, you get zero. Okay, so this is k dx by dt minus omega dt by dt is equal to zero. What is dx by dt? We have seen that if this represents a wave, transverse wave, wave is propagating along x-axis. Particle is undergoing displacement along y-axis. Wave is propagating along x-axis. So that means dx by dt represents the displacement, rate of change of displacement of the wave. That is the wave velocity. So this we have k, v, this v is the wave velocity. Minus omega is equal to zero. So k into v is equal to omega. So that means v is equal to omega by k. So this is another way of getting the relation between v, omega and k. So this was the brief introduction regarding the mathematical equation formation of wave, the relation between particle velocity and wave velocity, the second degree differential equation for the wave, d square y by dx square is equal to 1 by v square, d square y by dt square. And remember, this v is not the velocity of the particle, but this v is the velocity of the wave. So these are the things you need to be thoroughly clear before you proceed with the mathematical treatment for waves. So I hope I have made it a bit clear, and the equation formation of wave. And if you have any doubt on any specific steps, then you can post in the comments and I will surely reply them. I will try my best to help you. Okay, good luck.